Hi there, my name's Adam. I'm a fitness coach and a programme coordinator in the health and wellbeing team at the Tottenham Hotspur Foundation.
Hi everyone, my name is Belvin Lewis. I am a coach for the health and wellbeing department for Tottenham Hotspur Foundation.
Hi, I'm Katrina. I manage the health and wellbeing team at Tottenham Hotspur Foundation.
Today we've got some 15-minute workouts for you, some that you can do at home. Okay, so to start with, we're just going to warm up. So all that's going to take is us marching on the spot or jogging on the spot. Okay, what we're looking for here is to raise the heart rate at a slow and steady pace, but also bring the blood pressure up as well. If we dive straight into exercise, then the blood pressure goes up too quick. We don't want that. That could be quite dangerous. Also, we'd be exercising with cold muscles. So all you're going to do is nice and light on your toes, and you're going to use your arms to help with the momentum as well. Take some nice deep breaths. Going to start raising your knees up in front of you a little bit, just about 50%. We're going to gradually increase the intensity until we're ready to start working out. You never see a footballer jump straight into it. They always warm up before they go onto the pitch. Okay, let's start with some punches out to the front. Try and keep your fists up, try and keep your elbows up around shoulder height. It's good for your coordination as well. Remember to go at your own pace. We're going to go up to the ceiling now. Good stuff. Hands above the head, make sure that your core's nice and tight so you don't put any unnecessary pressure on your lower back. Next, we're going to push and we're going to pull. Push and pull. Still bringing our knees up. Push. Pull, push, pull. Fantastic. We're going to go one hand at a time now. Push forwards and pull back simultaneously. It's a test for your coordination. It's all right. You don't have to be marching on the spot, okay? If that distracts, you can slow it down. Push and pull. Fantastic. For another 3, 2, 1, and have a bit of a shake off. Good stuff, guys. Next up, we're going to pick in some imaginary apples, okay? Oh, yes. So you can watch to start with. Without shrugging my shoulders, I'm going to reach up, twist, and bring my elbows down.
I'll take a bite.
Up, twist, and back down if you want. Up, twist, back down. Good. Up, twist, and back down. And carry on jogging. Bring those knees up a little bit higher. Good. If you're starting to feel warm, if you're starting to get a little bit sweaty, that's good. Okay, next up we're going to do some knees to elbows, okay? And it's going to go across the body, left to right, right to left. As Katrina's doing, you can do it with your hands or with your elbows. Make sure you're bringing your knees up to your elbows, not your elbows down to the knees. Good. Make it a little bit harder, you can grab your ears. And go for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good stuff. Back into a nice light jog. Take some deep breaths, just compose yourselves. We've barely left this spot, okay? You don't need lots of room. Okay, next up, we're gonna do some star jumps, okay? We can have some half star jumps, or as Belvin's demonstrating, the full star jumps, okay? So off we go. 20 seconds or so. You can do all of this sat down as well if you need to. If you want, yeah. Last few seconds. 3, 2, 1, back on our feet, good. Last few seconds, guys. We're gonna ramp it up a little bit. It's well named, the warm-up, isn't it? Let's ramp it up a little, let's get those knees up. What we're gonna do next is some light squats, okay? So you're not gonna go all the way down, you're just gonna go 50% of the way down and then back up. So, feet nice and wide. As we go down, our hips go back, but our chest stays up. Good. Try to evenly distribute the weight across your feet as well. We'll edit the clicking out. Fantastic. Try and go a little deeper as well. Good, a few more seconds of speeding it up. 10 more seconds.
Yes.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax there, good. That's the warm-up complete. Workout number two, we're gonna do a resistance session with equipment, okay? Now we've got weights with us here, but there's so many different things you can use that are at home, okay? We're going with the same work to rest ratio, 40 seconds exercise and 20 seconds rest. Again, if you need to adjust that to suit your needs, that's absolutely fine. So our first exercise is a squat shoulder press, okay? So Katrina's gonna be using weights, Belvin's just using body weight, absolutely fine, okay? Good. So she's gonna squat down nice and gentle, then push the weights up over her head, fantastic. Now the key with resistance training is keeping those muscles under constant tension, okay? We don't wanna be resting at the top of the movement or at the bottom. That's it. As you start to fatigue, you may need to slow things down, okay? It's not about speed, it's all about the quality of these exercises. Fantastic. And I want you to think about the muscles that you're using as well. Excellent, keep going, guys. Good. So Belvin could add some weight. He could even have a rucksack or something like that that he could push over his head. Two water bottles. And relax there. So the next exercise we're going to do is lateral raises, okay? Lateral being out to the side. Katrina's gonna use the weights here. Fantastic. Now, what I'm gonna ask her to do is, because remember I said no resting in any of these motions, go up for me, just come down to my hands, now I'll go back up. If you haven't got weights at home, as Belvin's using water bottles here, that's absolutely fine, okay? Shopping bags would be fine as well. Now it is a very small muscle group, okay? So you don't need heavy weights for this, it's all about technique, okay? As Belvin sat down, he's unable to use momentum to help get the weights up as well. You feeling that? Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
The big guy and he's only using water bottles. Last few seconds then. Good. Go up and hold. Okay, resist. 3, 2, 1. Fantastic. Exercise number three, keeping it around the shoulder region, is gonna be a frontal raise. Okay, so again, Belvin's raising with the water bottles, Katrina's raising with the weights. Good. Notice again, Belvin's not using any momentum from his hips, generated from his hips, okay? It's all focusing on the anterior deltoid. Perfect. Now notice Katrina's getting a little bit slack at the bottom there. I'm gonna ask her to take the weights up. Just come down to my hands, then back up. Again, constant tension on the muscles. Good. I'd like you to turn your thumbs up. That's it. Good, keep that core braced as well. We're trying to stop the hips from doing this. Fantastic. Last few seconds. Good, keep it, don't touch my hands. For 3, 2, 1, relax. We're actually gonna work the back muscles now, and that's quite a difficult muscle group to work at home, but we're gonna find a way. Okay, now Katrina's demonstrating with some dumbbells. What I'm gonna ask you to do is just come, and I want the weight to come straight up from the floor, okay? So not at an angle, straight up. Make sure you pause at the top as well, okay? Pause at the top and then release under tension as well. Now Belvin's got a shopping bag there. I'm not sure what it's filled with. It doesn't look very heavy. A bag of apples maybe. But again, you can load some books in there, you could load some tins, anything like that. Perfect. And again, it's about keeping those muscles under tension, okay? So squeeze those shoulder blades together and release under tension. Squeeze and release, fantastic. Breathing very, very important, as Belvin's demonstrating as well. Make sure you keep breathing. Good. And relax there, well done. So the next exercise is a split squat. Again, we've got two variations, but there's multiple variations you can do to make it easier or harder. Okay, notice Katrina's got her back foot elevated. Okay, perfect. That's making it much, much harder. Okay, we're gonna do 20 seconds on each leg and then you're gonna switch. Now notice Belvin's only doing partial movements. That's helping to keep that muscle under tension. Okay, so he's gonna really start to feel that lactic acid building up in those muscles. Good, keep going, keep going. Last few seconds, guys. Good. Belvin could potentially hold some weight on his front. He could have a backpack on, something like that. Okay, and 3, 2, 1. Good, shake off your legs and then switch over. So what Katrina could do here is if she starts to fatigue, she could drop the weights down, okay, and just use her body weight. It's still resistance training. Good, Katrina, well done. And again, go to your range of motion. If you can go deeper, fantastic. If you can't, that's absolutely fine. Good, Belvin, well done. That's it. Come a little bit higher for me. Stand down, good, well done. Feeling it? Yeah? You could even have your little kid on your shoulders, anything like that. Keep going, guys. 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax there. Good work, guys. Well done. So the next exercise is going to help you fill out those tight T-shirts, okay? We're going to go into some bicep curls. So Belvin's demonstrating with some water bottles again. Now, we didn't get biceps like that working with water bottles, did he? But work to whatever weight you can do the exercise correctly, okay? Now, notice he's fully extending as well. He's fully extending at the elbow, lengthening that muscle and contracting at the top of the movement. Fantastic. Again, by sitting down, he's not able to use any momentum, okay? Good. Really good. And Katrina's giving us a demonstration with the dumbbells as well. If you have got dumbbells at home, fantastic. If not, some shopping bags, some tins will do absolutely fine. What I'd like you to do is just lean forwards a little bit, Katrina, and then bring it up there. Perfect. And it stops you getting any pain in your shoulders there. Perfect. That's it. So if you start to fatigue on this exercise, you can hold it isometrically, okay, where you just hold the weight still. So hold it at 90 degrees. Good. Hold it there and see how long you can hold it for. A bit of a competition with the rest of the family. And relax there, good. We're gonna do tricep kickbacks. Now you don't need a heavy weight for this, if any weight. Belvin's demonstrating without any weight at all. Okay, good. So what I'm gonna ask you to do, Katrina, is just decrease the angle at your hips, okay? So you're gonna come down a little further, bring your elbows up, and then kick back, fantastic. You'll feel that pinch a lot more. Now again, Katrina's probably not gonna be able to do 40 seconds with that. So what she's gonna do is she's gonna drop the weights and then just go into the movement without the weights. Good. If you do start standing up straight, put the weights down and go back to this, okay? Yep. Squeeze your shoulder blades a little bit more, mate. Pull your shoulders back, there you go, good. Now, if you've got tight shoulders, you may struggle with this movement a little bit, okay? But just do what you can. Find your range of motion. Good. Make sure you feel that pinch at the top as well, guys. Fantastic. Another 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. So our final exercise of this session is calf raises, okay? We've got weighted calf raises that Katrina's demonstrating here, and we've got body weight calf raises that Belvin's doing off the back of the chair. Now, if you want to make it a little bit harder, Belvin could stand his toes on some books or some weighted plates or something like that, so he's getting more of a stretch at the bottom of the movement. However, what we're looking for is for you not to put your heels on the floor, okay? So keep those calves under tension, and very quickly you'll start to feel a burn in the back of your calves, okay? That's what we're looking for. So this is like a pulsing movement, okay? Pulse, pulse, pulse. Keep it going. That's the pace that I want to see. Fantastic. Keep going. Well done. Keep that core nice and tight as well, okay? Helps you balance. Feeling it? Keep going, guys. 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly come down and relax there. Give your legs a shake off as well. So after your workouts, it's always key to cool down, okay? So what we're trying to aim for is to lower our blood pressure, lower our heart rate, okay? And just stretch off those tired muscles while they're warm, okay? So all we're gonna do, first of all, is just control our breathing by just hanging our arms down by our sides, nice and relaxed. As we breathe in, we're gonna take our arms up, cross at the top, breathe out, come back down, good. Breathe in, and breathe out. Good, 2 more times. And down, last one. And back down, fantastic. Shake off a little bit, good stuff guys. Keep breathing nice and deep. So next up we're gonna sweep. So you're gonna sweep back, slight bend of knees, reach up, hold for a second, and come back down. Up and hold at the top, but don't hold your breath, okay? Keep breathing normally. What we're gonna do from here is interlock our fingers and just lean very slightly over to your left or right hand side. Try not to lean forwards or backwards. And back up to the center and over to the opposite side, left or right. back to the centre, let the arms come down, have a bit of a shake off. Good stuff. Okay, next up, let's interlock our fingers, pushing our fists forward. We're going to bring our elbows in together and push our chest up. So you should feel a stretch across the back of your shoulders and your upper back. Yep, good stuff. Keep your airways open as well, guys. We're still taking some nice deep breaths. Perfect. From there, guys, we're going to go nice and wide, dropping our hands down to around about hip height. Palms facing forwards. Push your chest up, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Hold that for 3, 2, 1. Slowly relax. Fantastic. Feet slightly wider than shoulder width apart. We're going to lean our body weight over our right ankle. Good. Without leaning too far forwards or backwards. Keeping both feet firmly on the floor. Good. If you want to put your hands on your bent knee, that's fine. And slowly just shift your body weight.
Sorry. So you can do these in the chair, can't you?
Yeah. You can do all these from a chair as well, guys. Hold that for 3, 2, 1. Back up to the center. From there, take a deep breath in and reach down towards the floor. If you can reach the floor, fantastic. If not, just reach as far as you can. From there, you're going to go across your left toes. All right there, mate. And over to the right. Take a deep breath as you come back up. And relax there, good. Final stretch, guys, and then we're done. If you can, try and grab the laces of your right shoe. You're going to tuck your heel in. Knees together, push your hips forward, and hold. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out there, guys, okay? And switch over legs, exactly the same coaching points. Tighten up those glutes, push those hips forward. You shouldn't feel any pressure in your lower back. If you're spending a lot of time sat down, stretching out your hip flexors is very, very important, okay? Particularly if you're all working from home. Good, try and increase that for a final few seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it off there. Guys, great effort. Well done.
Well done,
everyone.